Yes, I'm sharing a question paper with you. You can see it yourself. Participate, read the question paper thoroughly, very carefully. Yes.
Read it very carefully, especially the highlighted words. The effect of the worst economic downturn. Downturn means recession. Downturn since the Great Depression are forcing changes on state governments and the US economy that could linger for decades. For one Federal Reserve estimate, the country lost almost an entire year's worth of economic activity, nearly $14 trillion during the recession from 2007 to 2009. The deep and persistent losses of the recession forced states to make broad cuts in spending and public workforces. For businesses, the recession led to changes in expansion plans and worker compensation. And for individual Americans, it has meant a future postponed as fewer buy houses and start families. 5 years after the financial crash, the country is still struggling to recover. In the aftermath of previous recession, there were strong recoveries. That is not true this time around, said the Gary Bustless, a senior fellow at the Brookings Institution. This is more like the pace getting out of the Great Depression. For years, housing served as the backbone of economic growth and as an investment opportunity that propelled generations of Americans into the middle class. But the financial crisis burst the housing bubble and devastated the real estate market, leaving millions facing foreclosure. Foreclosure means a type of bankruptcy. Foreclosure, millions and more underwater, and generally stripping Americans of years worth of accumulated wealth. Anthony B. Sanders, a professor of real estate finance at George Mason University, said, even the nascent housing said even the nascent housing recovery can't escape the effects of the recession. Home values may have rebounded, he said, but the factors driving that recovery are very different than those that drove the growth in the market in the 90s and 2000s. Sanders said more than half of the recent home purchases have been made in cash, which signals investors and hedge funds are taking advantage of cheap properties. That could freeze out average buyers and also means little real economic growth underpins those sales. Those effects are clear in home ownership rates, which continue to decline. In the second quarter of this year, the US home ownership rate was 65%, according to Census Bureau data, the lowest since 1995. In the mid-2000s, it topped 69%, capping a steady pace of growth that began after the early 1990s recession. Reversing that will be a challenge, in part because credit has triggered tightened and lending rules have been toughened in an effort to avoid the mistakes that inflated the housing bubble in the first place. Credit expanded and now contracted, and it's going to be tight like this as far as I can see, Sanders said. We so destroyed so many households when the bubble burst, there's just not the groundswell to fill the demand again. Some are skeptical that the tight credit market and new effects to regulate the financial markets like the Dodd-Frank law will prove lasting. Americans have often responded with calls for regulation after financial sector driven crisis and accusations of mismanagement, according to Brookings Bustless. But eventually those fires cool down, he said. It's not as though this memory of what can go wrong sticks with us long. That can be seen in the intense efforts to water down Dodd-Frank's regulations, Bustless said. Federal regulations have already made moves to relax requirements for some potential homeowners. who were victims of recent housing crisis. Even those steps and an unlikely return to easy credit might not fuel a full housing recovery without economic growth to back it up. As Sanders, referring to the growth in low wage and part-time employment, put it, at those wages, it's tough to scramble together down payments and mortgages. Read it very carefully, friends. Koi word samajh mein nahi aaye puchhiye, otherwise consult the dictionary so that everything is crystal clear. Turmoil. Turmoil means crisis. Turmoil in the housing market has already reshaped the makeup of household nationwide. The home ownership rates among people with children under 18 fell sharply during the recession, declining 15% between 2005 and 2011. According to Census Bureau data, in some states it was far worse. For Michigan, the decline in home ownership was 23%, and in Arizona and California, it was 22%. Lackluster job growth has outlived and downturn. A study by the Economic Policy Institute showed wages for all workers, when adjusted for inflation, grew just 1.5% between 2000 and 2007. But the last 5 years wiped out even those modest gains. The study found wages declined for the bottom 70% of all workers since the recession began. However, some areas have seen manufacturing jobs climb back from the recessionary lows, and energy sector has been a boon for some Midwestern states. One hopeful sign for workers is the shift away from manufacturing growth in the typically low wage South back towards Rust Belt states, reversing a movement that was taking hold before the downturn. The trend is documented in a 2012 report from the Brookings Institution, locating American manufacturing trends in the geography of production. From 2000 to 2010, both the Midwest and South lost manufacturing jobs at about the national rate of 34%, but the Midwest has seen nearly half of all manufacturing jobs gained since 2010, almost double the increase in the South. For Michigan, the growth was 19%, in Indiana 12%. Even with that growth, there are caveats. Auto workers unions have ceded growth with the companies on wage and benefits, for example, allowing new hires to work for lower pay and fewer benefits than those who have held their jobs longer. Unemployment remains stubbornly high in some states, and the jobs created have leaned heavily towards part-time and low-pay work. A study from the San Francisco Federal Reserve found the proportion of US jobs that are part-time is high, as many of the jobs lost during the recessions have not returned. Now try to answer these questions. According to the passage, plunge in the economy devastated the life of Americans. Now, four options are there. A, it has led to huge loss of revenues amounting to almost $14 trillion. Correct. Due to degrading economy, there has been voluminous cuts in spending. Correct. It has led to a wide scale increase in the number of people buying homes. No, it is not correct. So the answer is A and B. D is the right answer. What can be cited as the prime cause of economic slump? Economic slump ka prime karan kya tha? First, A, changes in expansion plan and worker compensation. No. The expansion of credit which has upheld the investment in manufacturing sector. C, the tight credit market which has resulted in decline of real estate businesses. No. D, deregulation of the financial markets which has slowed down the economy. No. And last option E, mismanagement of funds has led to huge confusion among the citizens. The best option out of them will be what can be cited as the prime cause of this economic slump. The prime cause of the economic slump was actually the bubble, the financial None of these options really fit well. Best option would be mismanagement of funds has led to huge confusions. You can say. Next question. Why have been the employers preferred part-time jobs to regular full-time jobs since the downfall in economy? The answer is to downslide the debt curtailed toward the organization. Second option, so that more number of jobs can be raised. Third, because lots of job lost during the recession have not returned yet. Third, only third is the best option. Next question. Home ownership has drastically decreased since the economic downturn. Explain. Because of the changes made in the credit laws, correct, due to a sudden shift in the nature of the federal towards the middle class Americans, no, due to sudden loss incurred in the real estate market of a large number of people, no, because people are making broad cuts in their spending, correct, but the best answer is A, because of changes made in the credit laws. Which of the following statement is are true in the context of passage? Federals are tightening the lending rules to avoid mistakes, correct? US economy could linger for decades due to the economic recession. There has been steep increase in the low pay work to reduce unemployment slowly but steadily. Yes, even after a decade of financial crisis, crash, the economy is still struggling to recover. Yes, D is right. First is also right. So A, B, C, D. All are right. A, B, C, D. But this option is not there. Which of the following is the most suitable title for the passage? The most suitable title would be the 2008 financial crisis impact still hurting states, or the economic downturn. A is the best answer.
Yes, sir. A.
A is the best answer. Next, choose the word which is most similar. अब downturn के जैसे का जैसा word कौन सा है यहाँ? First is operose. Second is aeonian. C is abatement, D is descent, E is procurement. तब downturn turn के जैसे का जैसा होगा descent. D S E N T descent means decline. Answer is D. Next, persistent. Persistent के जैसा कौन सा होगा? A is merciful, B is tenacious, C is intermittent, D is relenting, E is yielding. Best answer is B, tenacious. Now you have to find out the antonym, most opposite word. Choose the word which is most opposite. The word is foreclosure. Foreclosure ke opposite kya hoga? First is preclude, B is legalize, C is deprive, D allow, E prevent. तो फोर क्लोजर का ऑपोजिट क्या होगा? नियरेस्ट ऑपोजिट हो जाएगा अलाउ. फोर क्लोजर में क्या करते हैं? बैंकरप्ट कर देते हैं, प्रॉपर्टी जब्त कर लेते हैं. नियरेस्ट ऑपोजिट हो जाएगा अलाउ. उसके बाद ऑप्शन है लीगलाइज. स्केप्टिकल. स्केप्टिकल का नियरेस्ट ऑपोजिट क्या होगा? स्केप्टिकल का मतलब है ड्यूबियस, डिसेंटिंग, कन्विंस्ड. कन्विंस्ड इज ऑपोजिट ऑफ स्केप्टिकल, राइट. आंसर इज सी. Yes, friends. So best wishes. Keep working hard. I hope you try to do some practice in the class. Thank you all.